I came into this whole business of archiving quite late in life. I was in rural development before that, but it became very obvious in Afghanistan at a certain point that there's so many of the young generation were coming back from exile, being refugees in Iran and in Pakistan, and they didn't know beans about their history. They didn't even know much about the topography of their country. And therefore, they were lured into fast-tracking Kabul. Kabul is really a very energetic place, and you have jazz bands and you have all kinds of things which have been brought in from the West. But after a while, it all seems rather ephemeral, and it's not very satisfying. So we have this present phenomena, which is terrible. Thousands of people, almost every day, standing in the visa office trying to get passports to get out of Afghanistan. And yet, Afghanistan needs these educated young people. But they've given up. The future looks too bleak. The economy's in a mess. Security is very poor. And the services are not very well developed. So for many valid reasons, they want out. But a nation keeps its integrity only when its members hold fast to values from their history and their heritage. And they don't have any, because in the refugee schools, they never had any Afghan history. And it wasn't very well taught in Afghanistan either. They have no interest in history. They're only concentrated on surviving for the moment and what they're going to give their children for the future. So they want out. And this is disastrous. These are the people that Afghanistan needs for the future. So my dedication to collecting and disseminating simple, basic information, which started in Pakistan about 10 years earlier, when working with the rural areas, you need to convey basic knowledge about, you know, what are germs, where do they hide? And once you get the intention of the rural population, whether they're literate or not, once you get their intention and they believe that what you say is beneficial, they'll grab it and you can't catch them. So this was a basic motivation to get some basic information out there. And I was lucky enough. I had lots of people who were supporting me. In Afghanistan, it's usually who you know, not what you know. It would really put you with, okay. So I'm motivated to keep on with all this, because I think I would like to persuade some of the young people to stay and identify, but they don't have a sense of belonging now. They were too alienated. We've got to give them a sense of belonging by knowing their history.